In this chapter, we're going to look at the exciting world of video effects. In this one, we're going to look at how to apply a few effects and some tricks as well. And specifically, what we're going to try to be doing is trying to make this guy anonymous by blurring out his face. And there's a few different ways to do that, so this is just one way. Now, the first thing we need to do is we need to isolate just his face. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a search for Matt, M-A-T-T-E, in the effects panel. And what I'm looking for here is the 8-point garbage matte effect. This will give us some points to create a mask. So I'm going to apply. I'm just going to drag and drop this little plug icon where it says 8-point garbage matte and drag and drop this onto our video clip, just like we do with audio effects. So if we click this here, go to the effect controls panel, and you can see that we have 8-point garbage matte here in the effect controls panel. Now, in the effect controls panel, when you see this little icon here, there's little light dots with an arrow. That means that if we click the effect to select it, that we have these points to adjust. And these are the effect control points. Now, I might want to get this a little bit smaller so I could see the edges. And then I'm going to drag these points, these little circles with pluses on them there. I'm going to click and drag and move this around or move these points around until I've got the face isolated. So this is a good way to create a mask. And the purpose of these effects, the garbage matte effects, as you'll see, there's 4 points, 8 points, and 16 points, is when you're creating a green screen to create an initial mask to get rid of the extra stuff, like if there's like a boom mic or something like that, to get that out of the shot before removing the green screen. But this also can be used for purposes just like this, where we're isolating a component of the video. Now, the obvious problem here, of course, is that the mask has actually not only isolated the face, but removed the entire background as well. And we still need the background there. So what we're going to do is make a copy of this. And what we're going to do is have the top copy be just the face and the edited version of the face. And the bottom copy below is going to be the regular video. So what I'm going to do to copy this clip is to select it in the timeline panel and then hit Command-C or Control-C on your keyboard to copy it. Then I'm going to click the video one track here to deselect it or untarget it. And then I'm going to click video track two to target it because you can only paste into targeted tracks. And then I'm going to hit the home key. So I'm at the first frame of my timeline and then making sure that I do not have video track one selected. And I do have video track two selected or targeted. I'm going to hit command V or control V on the PC to paste this clip. And so now we have two copies of the same clip. Now I'm going to select the bottom one, making sure that the top one is not selected. And then I'm going to delete the garbage matte effect by selecting it in the effect controls panel and hitting delete to remove it. So now we have, it seems like the original clip, but really we have a masked version on the top and the original on the bottom. So if we were to take off the visibility of the bottom track, we have the face on the top here and then everything on the bottom. Now we can go ahead and distort or alter this top clip. Let's go ahead and do another search here. I'm just going to click in the search field, highlight this. Let's just do a search for mosaic. And what I want is in the video effects stylized category, mosaic. Go ahead and drag and drop this onto the A-roll clip on the top, not the bottom here, on the top. Now, that's kind of what we're going for. But we do need to adjust this because we can kind of still see through underneath and these blocks aren't all that great. So I'm going to open up the mosaic effect here in the effect controls panel. Again, making sure that the top clip that we've applied a mosaic to is selected. Open up mosaic, and here we can control how many horizontal blocks there are and how many vertical blocks there are. I'm going to go ahead and click this right facing chevron here so I could see this a little bit better. And I'm going to go ahead and increase the number of horizontal blocks and increase the number of vertical blocks. And we don't want it too much because then we could see who it is. But we could obscure it, something like this maybe. And that's looking pretty good. If we wanted to get more intense colors, we could choose sharp colors. Obscures things a little bit better in this case, so we could leave it there. And now as we preview this, then we can see that our character is obscured. We don't know who he is. Now there are times like this where his face moves outside of where the mosaic is because he moves and we are not moving the mosaic area. So what we might need to do in those cases is to actually change the position or animate the position of this clip. So maybe like while we're right here and it works, we can go open up motion, click the stopwatch for position, and then as it moves outside a little bit, we can move this layer over a little bit to make sure he's all covered up there. So this is just one way to do it. We could also go back to our 8-point garbage mat and just make it a little bit bigger to encompass more of this area so we don't have to animate it if we want to do that. So that's how to censor video. If you need to, again, get rid of like product placement, if there's something visually that you're not seeing or you're not wanting to see, or if you need to keep a character, maybe an interviewee, anonymous, this is a great way to do it. And it's also a good exercise as we've learned how to apply effects, how to delete effects, how to adjust effects, and also how to copy and paste clips. So a lot of information in this one little trick.